Welcome back to the foodie finale of tonight's show. Kwanghi Chan is busy in the kitchen. Hello, Kwanghi.
Hi, guys.
How are you doing? Remind us what we're having.
So we're doing a lemon chicken, so a classic Chinese takeaway dish. Not many people have it anymore, but it's still on the menu.
Why do you? Really? People don't get it?
Like, normally people order sweet and sour or curry, or black bean sauce. Like, do you ever order lemon chicken? Or have you ordered takeaway?
Yeah, not from the takeaway, but in restaurants, yes.
Oh, do you? Yeah, right, okay. Yeah. So it must be a posh thing, so that's what I'm going to make there. So. Yeah, so we're doing posh chicken, lemon chicken.
What?
It must be a posh thing, so since you order it in restaurants.
Yeah.
You're very posh, Mark.
Kwanghi, I'm going to put you in the car someday and bring you to where I grew up. You will completely disregard what thought you might have.
So I have some diced chicken here, okay? So and I threw some soy sauce in there just to get a bit of flavour and marinating in it. Mm-hmm. And what we're going to do is I'm going to throw a small bit of the Shaoxing cooking wine, okay? This is the Chinese sherry. So if you don't have it, just not too much, just a little bit. That's all you need.
And not too much. One of our researchers had a sniff of it and we had to sit him down.
We had to call a taxi, isn't that right? Colin's like, whoa!
Are you okay? Yeah. So, but that'll give it a lovely kind of flavour. So if you don't have the this Shaoxing wine, use the Chinese sherry or a nice sherry, so just a drop of it and give it a nice flavour. And what I'm doing is you can use flour or my favourite, potato flour.
Potato flour.
So I'm using potato flour. That gives it a nice and crisp. So that's all I'm going to do. So I have an oil on here, and the way to test the oil is, whether it's hot enough if you're doing what I'm doing, is you can see the chopstick starts to bubble. So if you get a wooden skewer as well, that will work too.
Okay.
And that's when you know, like, that's around maybe 100, and if you're going to do it 175 degrees, okay?
Right, yeah.
You can do it in deep fryer as well. Just give it a shake, access. Just throw that in there, and that will be nice and crispy.
In you go.
And when that is cooking, what we're going to do is we're going to make the lemon sauce. So.
But there's a squeeze of lemon in there already, so we're just going to enhance it a little bit more.
Yeah, so I'm just going to give it a little stir. Just to give it a, so it doesn't really stick together, okay? So I love crispy chicken, this is great. So.
Yes, I'm just about to say thank you for making so much. It's dinner time here after the 6 o'clock show for the crew, so Kwanghi always knows to make a little bit more, fair play to him.
Yeah, so next. What I'm gonna do is, I'm gonna put this stuff away. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna make the sauce. Sauce is very simple. I have some oyster sauce here. I squeeze some lemon in there. So I say I have one lemon in there, I'm gonna squeeze another one. Just get fresh lemon juice. If you don't have fresh lemon juice, you can use lemon cordial as well. That'll work too, okay?
Lemon cordial?
Yeah, lemon cordial, yeah. You know,
really?
The diluted stuff, yeah.
That's a posh word, isn't it, for lemonade?
lemonade, Martin, yes. Throw some lemonade in there.
Can you use that stuff you use for Pancake Tuesday? Can you use that, the Jif stuff for Pancake Tuesday?
You can use that as well, yeah.
Excellent.
Do you use that for your pancakes, do you?
Yes, I do. Yeah. Proud of it.
So what I'm going to do is I'm going to throw that in there. And oyster sauce, lemon juice, a bit of water, or you can use chicken stock if you want as well.
Okay.
And I'm going to sweeten it up with a bit of honey. You can use sugar if you don't have honey at home.
Okay.
Honey's quite nice, and it's quite natural as well, so. And what we're going to do is...
You put in quite a bit of honey there. Say you were using sugar, what would you think people should do?
About maybe... Because you need to balance it, like this is quite, citrusy. So you want maybe 2 tablespoons, what I mean?
Okay.
So just to give that sweetness. And you can taste it as well if you want. So what I'm going to do is, I have some potato flour here, a bit of water. And what we're going to do is try to thicken this up. You can see it starts getting gloopy. And you want this quite a little bit gloopy, because you want it to coat the chicken, okay? Mm. So I think we're nearly there, guys, you know that?
One thing I'd always
say. So you can see that there coming up, bubbling away, and that's what you want. And the chicken is lovely and crispy. So
if you're a fan of doing Kwanghi's recipes, get the potato flour. He uses it every day.
It's worth getting because it's quite nice and crispy.
Potato flour, people. Why aren't you sponsoring Kwanghi? I mean, come on, you never stop talking about it.
So here we go, you see? And what I've done here is, you can see the lemon chicken there. So we're going to do a slice of a bit of spring onions on top.
Ooh.
Okay.
And the honey is what helps it stick to the chicken.
Yeah, and the potato flour as well, yeah. So they give it a bit of sweetness. And what I've done
is...
You
just won't stop with the potato flour, will you?
No,
yeah. And I have some rice vermicelli here as well. So what I did is rice noodles, and I deep-fried it in that thing. And at about 175 degrees, it puffs up, OK?
Hold on. Did you just put the rice straight in?
What?
Did you put the noodle straight in?
Straight into the deep fryer, and it comes up like puff, you know? So like Rice crispy.
That looks beautiful.
Yeah, so what you do is you throw this on top of it, OK? And you get this lovely...
You can hear it
crackle and pop.
Yeah.
Isn't that brilliant? So...
That looks absolutely delicious.
Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to garnish it with a couple of slices of lemon, as you do. And I have a couple of little garnishes here as well, so...
Right, I know you always use the... You know, you always use the oil yourself because you're very comfortable around the pot with the oil.
Yeah.
But all can be done in the deep fat fryer. It's no big deal.
But you can do this in the deep fat fryer and just have your sauce at the side and just throw it in there.
That's what you can do.
Like, you know what I mean? So, yeah, so that's it. Lemon chicken. I actually did it faster than the takeaway.
We'd still be waiting.
Uh-huh.
We'd be waiting for it. Like, Emmerdale would be over and we'd still be waiting.
Stop slagging it.
Look at
stop
that. That's just amazing.
Stop slagging off the takeaways. Isn't How's it? Everything going at work?
Great, yeah. We're opening back up again, so we're trying. Aww. So, yeah.
You're opening back up again.
We open back up, so
come
yeah.
on. In bowls.
Thank you. We open up bowls again, yeah. So
we're opening up bowls again.
We're just doing Monday and Friday at the moment, just testing out the grounds and see how we get on. So,
but if you are doing a holiday in Dublin, or if you live in Dublin,
yeah,
and you haven't been to bowls, please do try it out. It's absolutely.
I just love the whole idea
delicious.
Of that, just as a big sharing dish in the middle of the table, and people just tuck in.
Oh,
although
thank you
that
so
does
much.
Look like Muireann's portion right now.
It does. Let's not talk about last night. I ate all of Owen's pasta last night. That's bad. A message from my mother. I must try that lemon chicken. Sorry, thank you, Mary. That just popped up there on my screen.
Yay! Don't worry.
Okay.
Our iPads are broken.
Mary checks the show every evening. Thanks for that, Mary.
Thanks, Mary.
We got a message in here. It says, big hello to Rob in Donnybrook, who's sporting his 6 o'clock show apron this evening. There he is.
Hey, Rob.
Hi, Rob.
Thank you, sir.
Rob is a big fan of the show and watches every day to relax after a busy day working at the bank. And look at him, he's actually cooking as well. Do you think he can do the lemon chicken?
The lemon chicken.
He can absolutely can do the lemon chicken.
6 PM TV, Rob, if you need to recreate it and you need some help along the way, that's where you'll find all that.
Well, that's it, because we are still sending out the aprons, by the way. If you send in for comments, you do still get the aprons. We are sending that. So it's good to see. We love getting the pictures of them. So it's always
And it looks clean as well. It looks as if Rob is
It looks like it's new.
It's found a good home with Rob. By the way, if you have one, let us know.
Yeah, do. Send us in pictures. We absolutely love
them. We want to see the photograph.
Because Kwanghi won't wear his. Do you notice that? His white T-shirt, and he's absolutely fine with it all. But just let everyone know, as always, the recipe is going to be up on our YouTube page, and also you can find it by Googling 6 Eats.
Okay, that's all we've got time for tonight. Big thank you to all of our guests and to Kwanghi for the dinner.
Thank you, Kwanghi.
Thanks, guys. Thank you very much.
I'll be back tomorrow with Ray. We'll be chatting to former Irish rugby player CJ Stander, because Martin's going on his holidays, everybody.
Yay!
Much deserved. Have a lovely night, and we'll talk
to you. Take care of yourselves. Bye-bye.
Bye.